Welcome to Exams Daily YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to see the daily current affairs of June 28, 2019. Before that, the Zorian subscriber Exams Daily YouTube channel, click the subscribe button and also do not forget to click the bell button to get updates from our YouTube channel. NDMA to conduct multi-state earthquake mark exercise in Delhi. The NDMA, National Disaster Management Authority, in collaboration with the state governments, is going to conduct a mock exercise on earthquake preparedness on June 28, 2019. The aim of this mock exercise is to improve preparedness and response mechanism of the local administration in the event of an earthquake. And this exercise will cover Delhi, that is all 11 districts of Delhi, and in Haryana 4 districts, Jajhar, Faridabad, Gurugram and Sonipat, and in UP 3 districts, that is Gautam Buddh Nagar, Ghaziabad and Meerut. So this mock exercise of the NDMA related to multi-state earthquake is going to be held in Delhi. So this NDMA, National Disaster Management Authority, is an agency of the Ministry of Home Affairs, and its primary purpose is to coordinate response to natural or man-made disasters and for capacity building in disaster resiliency and crisis response. This NDMA was established through the Disaster Management Act of the Government of India in 23rd, which was enacted in 23rd December 2005. And the ex officio chairman of this NDMA is Prime Minister. So here we can expect the question that this NDMA is going to conduct this multi-state earthquake mark exercise in which place, that is in Delhi. VAPCO celebrates Golden Jubilee. The VAPCO's Water and Power Consultancy Services Limited, which was incorporated as public sector enterprise in 1969 by the Government of India, celebrated its Golden Jubilee at Siri Fort in New Delhi. In commemoration of this historic occasion, the company, that is VAPCO's, organized this Golden Jubilee celebration with the theme title Transcending Boundaries, Touching Lives. So this VAPCO celebrated its Golden Jubilee at Siri Fort, New Delhi, and it was incorporated in 1969. So this VAPCO's Limited is a Mini Ratna public sector enterprises under the aegis of Union Ministry of Jal Shakti, and it was incorporated on June 26, 1969 under the Companies Act. And this is a leading technology-driven consultancy and EPC organization with strong global presence in the field of water, power and infrastructure sectors. So here we can expect the question that this VAPCO, the public sector enterprise, was formed in which year? It was formed in 1969. BIMSTEC Day celebrated in Dhaka. The members of the 7 countries, that is a regional grouping, Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation, BIMSTEC, and the members of the 7 countries of this BIMSTEC group celebrated the BIMSTEC Day in Dhaka, that is in Bangladesh. So this BIMSTEC is a sub-regional organization came into being in 1997 through the Bangkok Declaration. And initially it was formed with 4 member states with the name BIMSTEC, that is Bangladesh, India, Sri Lanka and Thailand Economic Cooperation. And it became renamed BIMSTEC in 1997 following the inclusion of Myanmar. And with the admission of Nepal and Bhutan in 2004, the name of this grouping was changed to BIMSTEC, that is Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation. So Nepal and Bhutan joined in 2004 and Myanmar joined later in 1997 after the formation of this BIMSTEC. So in 2004, Nepal and Bhutan joined. So now there are 7 countries, that is 5 of them South Asia, that is Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Nepal, Sri Lanka, and 2 from Southeast Asia, Myanmar and Thailand. So here we can expect the question that the BIMSTEC Day 2019 was celebrated in which place? It was celebrated in Dhaka. International Convention, New Delhi, to mark International MSME Day. The Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises recently organized an international convention on the theme Indian MSMEs Global Aspiration in New Delhi to observe the International MSME Day, which was observed on June 27. And further, as a part of continued celebration, the second edition of this International SME Convention will be held from 28th to 29th June 2019. So here we can expect the question that the Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises organized an international convention on the theme Indian MSMEs Global Aspiration, which place, and that is in New Delhi. 32nd Congress of the International Seed Testing Association. The 32nd Congress of the International Seed Testing Association was started in Hyderabad with Union Minister of State for Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Kailash Chowdhury, formally inaugurating this 8-day event. So the Union Minister of State for Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Kailash Chowdhury, inaugurated this event and it started in Hyderabad. The Seed Congress is being held for the first time in the South Asia. So this International Seed Testing Association, it was founded in 1924 and has more than 100 members worldwide. It is an association of laboratories which are authorized to check on the marketability of seed as defined in various countries' laws. So the headquarters of this International Seed Testing Association is in Switzerland. So here we can expect the question that 32nd Congress of the International Seed Testing Association was held in which place? It was held in Hyderabad. Meeting of Expert Working Group of Paris Pact Initiative of UNODC. The Department of Revenue, Ministry of Finance in New Delhi hosted a meeting, that is a meeting of Expert Working Group on Paris Pact Initiative on illicit financial flows deriving from the trafficking of opiates originating in Afghanistan. So this meeting was organized by the Department of Revenue, Ministry of Finance in New Delhi. The meeting consists of sessions spread over 2 days, that is June 27 and 28, and was organized with the support of United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, that is UNODC. This Paris Pact, it is a group of 58 countries and 23 international organizations affected with the drug trafficking of Afghan opiates. Under the ambit of this UNODC, this Paris Pact initiative has addressed the issue of drug problem related to the opiates originating in Afghanistan, both at policy and implementation level. So here we can expect the question that this meeting of Expert Working Group of Paris Pact Initiative of UNODC was held in which place? It was held in New Delhi. Central Sector Scheme TMA. The Ministry of Commerce and Industry Piyush Goyal informed recently that the government has brought out a new central sector scheme named TMA, that is Transport and Marketing Assistance Scheme, and it is for specified agriculture products for providing assistance for the international component of freight to mitigate the freight disadvantage for the export of agriculture products and marketing of agriculture products. So here we can expect the question that the Minister of Commerce and Industry brought out a new central sector scheme, that is TMA, Transport and Marketing Assistance, for specified which products, and that is for agriculture products, that is for the export of agriculture products and marketing of agriculture products by providing assistance. MOA signed to set up Center for Inland and Coastal Maritime Technology. A memorandum of agreement was signed between the Ministry of Shipping and IIT Garakpur for setting up the Center for Inland and Coastal Maritime Technology at IIT Garakpur. And this center will focus on indigenization of ship designing, building and testing. So here we can expect the question that this MOA signed to set up a Center for Inland and Coastal Maritime Technology in which IIT, that is in IIT Garakpur. Niti Aayog CEO Amitabh Kant's get extension. The Niti Aayog CEO Amitabh Kant tenures were extended by 2 years. The appointment committee of the cabinet approved the extension of tenure of the Amitabh Kant for a further period of 2 years, that is beyond June 30, 2009, that is up to June 30, 2021. So for 2 years. And he was appointed as the CEO of the government think tank in 2016, that is CEO of Niti Aayog in 2016 for a fixed 2 years term. And he was later given an extension till June 2019. So now his tenure was extended for another 2 years, that is up to 2021. And he is a 1980 batch Kerala cadre IAS officer. And Mr. Amitabh Kant was previously serving as the secretary in the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion in the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Here we can expect the question that who is the current CEO of Niti Aayog, and that is Amitabh Kant. Girish Kaushik is India's 63rd Grandmaster. Girish A. Kaushik, who is 22 years old and he is from Mysuru, and he became the India's 63rd Grandmaster at the 37th Balaton International Chess Festival, which was held in Hungary. So here we can expect the question that who is India's 63rd Grandmaster, and that is Girish A. Kaushik, and this 37th Balaton International Chess Festival was held in Hungary. In the description box below this video, we have given the daily and monthly current affairs link. We have also given the quiz link. If you want to attend this daily current affairs as quiz, you can use that link. Hope this will be useful. Thank you.